Welcome everybody to a new Legacy video, playing today a pet deck of mine, Death Shadow, a deck that I really like, a deck that only plays one Underground Sea, but you can also play, only plays two Underground Sea, but you can also go as far as playing one or even zero if you really want to play Legacy and you don't want it and you don't own any. But yeah, so this is a deck that a very good Italian player, MM17, played to a top 8 Legacy Challenge finish, and it's playing a new card. It's Ethereal Forger. It's replacing Gurmagangler for it, and I look at this list, I'm like, you know, that looks interesting. We can make that into a Legacy video. What are the ups and downs of Gurmagangler versus Ethereal Forger? So on one side, you have a 7 mana 5-5 with Delve, and on the other side, you have a 6 mana 3-3 flying that whenever it attacks, you may return an instant or sorcery card you exiled with its Delve ability. So what does this mean is that this Gurmagangler is a very large creature. You can only take it down with usually only Sorcery Plowshare because it's immune to Lightning Bolt or Abrupt Decay, which are two of the most popular removal spell in the format. Whereas if you're a Forger, dies to Lightning Bolt, which is definitely one of the most popular spell around. But on the other hand, Ethereal Forger is a blue card, so you can pitch it to the six forces. And it's also, you know, basically has the quote-unquote Dreaded Arcanist vibe, where if they let you untap with it, you just immediately gain value. Doesn't even have to survive combat, but it's just gonna give you back, I don't know, a Force of Will against a combo deck, or a Brainstorm, a Ponder, and stuff like that. So that's the differences between the two cards, and we are trying new stuff for the viewers, and this is a good one to see. The rest of the deck is pretty much the same one. You have Snuff Out, Fatal Push as a removal spell. You have Thoughtseize, Forces, Daze as permissions. You have Death Shadow, Ethereal Forger, Brazen Borrowers, and of course, Delver as threats, and then you have Forces, straight Brainstorm Ponders, and Straight Rate as cantrips. The mana base is only 5 lands that produce mana, so you have 5 lands, 4 wasteland, and 9 fetch lands. Or maybe I'm miscounting, but I hope I didn't. The sideboard has the usual Plague Engineer, Liliana Last Hope against creature decks, as well as one Fatal Push. Ratchet Bomb is for Chalice of the Void. More Brazen Borrower and Caracas for 2020. Cage is kind of a catch-all. Surgical for Graveyard. And finally, Hymn to Turak for the card advantage bottles, but watch out for Veil of Summer. This is a Legacy video on the YouTube channel, which is free. And if you want to support the channel, you can go to CFB Pro, where you can read all type of articles from Standard to Legacy, of course. And this stream is this video is also sponsored by Ultimate Guard, which is the best usage to protect your paper cards to play with your friends over on Discord, or for the lucky ones in those safe parts in the world, even playing paper. And yeah, let's go ahead and play some Magic, shall we? On the play with Delver of Secrets, that's a great hand over here. When registering Death Shadow, you don't have to be afraid of shocking yourself in the dark, because against the Lightning Bolt strategy, against like, let's say a blue-red Delver, if you don't have a Death Shadow in your hand, you can go ahead and just go like Underground Sea if you don't have a Death Shadow around. But in the dark, you just have to get Watery Grave, because you'll never know what matchup you're encountering, and they might not deal you any damage at any point, and you really need to take the opportunity to just damage yourself like this. So we go turn one Delver, your turn. They have 8 cards, so they kept 7. All right, all good. Let's see, what are we playing against? If it's a Chalice of the Void, we have to counter. If it's a Mystic Sanctuary, then it's okay. Ooh, Lotus Petal, so this might be Omnitel. Weird sequencing, but okay. Here I thought of playing control deck, and here I'm thinking for sure to playing Show and Tell, playing like one of Mystic Sanctuary. Very nice opponent, saying me nice things. All right, I think I'll go ahead and brainstorm here. As much as you don't want to do that, yeah, I do want to do that right now. This is perfect. So I'm gonna shuffle away a push, revealing Delver with Ponder, draw a card. And since I'm expecting them to play a combo deck, I'll go ahead and Thoughtseize. Now I'll turn on the window for a days to be active, but right now I just want to take away their show and tell. Oh, Veil of Summer. Oh wow. Yeah. So I didn't expect a Veil of Summer. I guess I have to force. No, you know what? It's fine. Just draw your card. All right. Cryptic Command. It's not even Cryptic Command because they use the Lotus Petal, so it's good. It's a good deal, but we've took away their petal, and we'll be moving on. I don't really want to play Under Gaze with my Force of Will if I can afford to. I'm still thinking that. I mean, they'll of course play an unfair strategy with Lotus Petal. Okay, I'll begin with a straight right here, and then I'll go Ponder. We're looking for, of course I'm taking Force. Looking at that shadow, I think a land is actually better than that shadow. But first, let's take this Force. Then let's attack for three. Now this is my turn three. I could play Brainstorm or Ponder. But I really, to like get that land to play around days. But at that point, I wouldn't have two pitch up. So here, ideally, I play a Death Shadow 1/1 with a land on top. It'll attack for four next turn, which I think it's good enough. I do have two Force, so like if they have Show and Tell plus days, I'm fine. I mean, I lose it all, so I'm not that fine, but sort of fine. So I intentionally missed the land drop here. There it is. They pitched Omniscience, so they don't have a daze, so my play actually went well. They're on 13. I'll knock them down a four here. And next turn they're dead with three cards in hand. All right, we got this. Yeah. I would say that this is a pretty typical game of Legacy. If you're new to this format, this is exactly. If you think about a Legacy game, what do you have in mind? I personally have in mind a Force of Will Delver deck against a combo deck, where the combo deck tries to go off on turn three with double backup, and the aggro deck just has two counters of their own with fast pressure to kill them on turn five. All right, this is definitely a good game. Now, I'm playing against Show and Tell, but not the typical side, because my opponent was playing Omniscience. So they're playing Omnitail. I don't like Surgical against Omnitail. I still think Caracas is good because they might just go for like Show and Tell Emrakul, and you just have to respect that side of the deck. I mean, this is pretty easy sideboarding. I don't think I need to change my deck at all. Even the Wastelands would have been good in this game. Again, I don't like Surgical. Surgical against Show and Tell usually doesn't really matter because you already have a, you're already like won the counter war, which is important. Yeah, I just go with this. Game number two, this end is clearly a mulligan. And even if one of these cards was a straight raid, it would have been a mulligan. Don't, please, please don't keep zero landers with a straight raid with this deck. I just remember because so often I see, those type of keeps. No, don't do that. All right, let's keep this one. I can bottom a Caracas or a Wasteland, and I really think that Caracas I mean, if you bottom Karrakas in this matchup, then why do you have it? That's a good point. Karrakas is mainly for the, I'd say, 2020 deck. I mean, of course, it's good here as well, but here I'm just bottoming it. I'm just bottoming it here. I just think that the other six cards are good, and Wasteland is good, especially if you don't have lands. And if, you know, if the game ends up where, in a spot where I need a deck Karrakas to win, then, you know, I'll take the hit on camera. Eureka, wow, okay, I'll take that one. Opponent Sandy is Wasteland proof. As you can see, Karrakas does nothing. If your opponent has Omniscience, Karrakas just literally does nothing. But not a Wasteland does something. They're both pretty awful. Alright, thank God I drew a Ponder. Ugh. This is pretty terrible, but I don't feel like shuffling these. But wow, this is bad. Alright, yeah. Just do like this and no shuffle. I'll pass. I really don't want to play Wasteland. I'd rather shuffle that away with a Brainstorm next turn. That's the problem with that shadow. It isn't a threat. And that is something relevant. Alright, I think I just want to force this. I just want to force this because my opponent hand is just bad. I don't want them to like shuffle that. Should make a land drop though. Yeah. Alright. Cast this Brainstorm. I know the top card. There it is. That's the polluted delta that saves the day. Alright. Do I wanna I think I'll shuffle away that shadow here. Because what I'll do here is now go to 12, cast a 1/1 shadow. Pass. Now I'll I can cast Ethereal Foragers next turn. See, that's another thing that happened in this game. I intentionally missed my second land drop because Wasteland isn't a land. It's a spell, okay? Don't misview Wasteland as a land. I think I'm casting Ethereal Forager. You know, this is a spot where this card is much, much better than Gurmagangler. Because next turn, as I attack, I'll be able to get back, I don't know, Thoughtseize, you know, and that's just great because it even increases the Death Shadow as well as like doing other stuff. So you can see the power of this wheel right now, you know, a Gurmagangler, sure, it could have been like a threat, but I would have most likely just, I don't know, not sideboarded away, but close to that. All right. Point on doing some deck thinning over there. Oh no, they're not doing that thinning. They're actually putting Eureka on top of their deck. I didn't see that coming. Sure. Eureka from the Legends. Very expensive card. Okay, so the Daze is a good pitch. And it will be. That's what it'll be. Pretty strong Mystic Sanger, isn't it? Alright, they have three cards and two of them are Omniscience. Even if they force back, they will be left only with Omniscience. Of course, I can't let Eureka resolve. Right, that shadow is slightly larger now. Do I want, you know what, here, I'll just attack with my Foragers and my shadow, get back a Force of Will, and now look, I have a Force of Will in my hand. Isn't it great? This is something nice. That shadow, your turn. Not moving. We're moving, not moving. I have a Force against a Show and Tell. No need to move. Nowhere to go. You know, this gives me the Dreaded Arcanist vibe, where you basically like a turn one clock. Like you attack with Foragers, game over. All right, here I'll get back, think Thoughtseize, because I, you know, that Omniscience alone doesn't win the game. So I want to take away the payoff that they have together with Omniscience. If there's none, then I just can't lose because I have a Force of Will in my hand. Yeah, I don't think it can go. I don't think anything can happen at this point. So I won't even bother casting that brainstorm. Because the game is locked up thanks to our Thera Foragers. I mean, we might have won the game with Gurmagenglar regardless, but my opponent literally never drew a spell after that brainstorm. That's pretty impressive. Yeah, they're casting something. Whatever happens here, all force of will. And I know the rest of their hand, so that's a GG. So yeah. GG. GG opponent, and I'll be back for round number two. Round number two, we're on the draw. I'm playing against Flying Whales, which is also present in my list. My list does have three Ethereal Forager. I'm curious if my opponent is also playing that strategy, considering their nickname. Oh, look at that. That's a lot of our secrets. Opponent with Island. Go. Back it. I hate to say this, but as much as we love to now play with basic island, I think it's still correct to play snow-covered island. There's basically no downside, and band control with Icefang Quaddle did win the last Legacy Challenge, so you know, just going island just already tells me that you're not playing control, which is yeah, I mean, considering that is a free tail, sure, you might just want to play your, I don't know what, two ticks island. That's fine. Yeah, I mean, I respect that, but I'm just saying that. Okay. Sure. Okay, I've never seen this before. What's this? I mean, I know it's a card box because I can read, but I didn't know it was a card. And I do play a lot of, even like, I read a lot of, like, you know, people selling and buying cards. I just never saw this art. I don't have a shop, but I really love doing Magic shopping. Wow, opponent is on like mono different art. Okay, they played a Doc Faden, and this is like the first regular card that I've played. Hey, I think I'm just gonna daze that, considering that I don't even have a land drop, so it's kind of like a dazed. Such a beautiful picture. Dazed. Do they have Sinnoh Spirit Guide? Nope, they'll let it go. All right, also I have no clue what my opponent's playing, obviously. Like Chromox, Torch of Defiance, Doc Faden. Dalvar, what do you do? Do you reveal a spell or not? You don't. No, thanks. I revealed the Wasteland though, which I'm probably just gonna cast on that Volcanic Island. That Volcanic Island is telling me. It's calling me. Calling for Mangle. And then I'll attack for one. Had I went to Force of Negation, I could have now cast a Brainstorm, but I don't know. I just don't really want to just cast a Brainstorm like this. Okay, they'll play second bulk. Pass. Do we flip it? We do not, but we flip. We get a three rate. Which I could cycle right now. I think I will actually. Because I could find another Wasteland. Or Brainstorm too. Okay, I'll pass. I'll go Brainstorm end of turn. The infamous end of turn Brainstorm to set up my Delver flip. Okay, that's a fourth mana. Ooh, look at that. Look at this Flying Whale. I'll shuffle away one of these cards, and I think it'll be a Fatal Push. Yeah, and I want to flip with, like a Brainstorm, yeah, because like basically flipping with a Brainstorm doesn't say anything. Whereas if I flip with Snuff out, my opponent can't go, I don't know, cannot cast an Inferno Titan or stuff like that. So that's flipped. I'm attacking for three. Now I could cast another Delver and flip, but I think I'm just going for another tier. But actually, you know what? I'm probably just going to bounce this Chromox and upkeep. Now, I was thinking about lots of plays, but I think that one actually makes the most sense. Yeah, that shuts off like another card out of my opponent's hand. They might not have it, so that might just be like a time walk, sort of. Yeah, and I'm actually just going to get an Underground Sea. Because I don't know why, but I feel like my opponent is playing like sneak and show. Some sneak and show. Infernal Titan things. I don't know why, obviously. I have like no ideas of what's going on, but that's just my guts. Force of Will, pitching Force of Will. Okay, you can keep your Girl Mox. Chalice of the Void. Huh. I mean, this of course shuts off a large chunk of my deck, but I might just not care. I have an Ethereal Forger, a Snuff Out, a Force of Negation. I think I'll let this resolve. And now, again, many cards of my deck will basically be neutralized, but I'll now go Foragers that can bring back a Daze next turn. An opponent's now has a 2-turn clock, a 0 and 11 with F6 power. You ideally want to always, of course, delve instants or sorceries. This is kind of like a lesson on basically don't use your counters if it isn't like needed. And I don't think it was needed. Maybe I like force that chalice and they just go like Shuenta Emrakul and I lose, you know? Okay, something is happening end of turn. It's a Deceiver Exarch. Okay. I can go double Daze, but I'm not going to. I don't need my mana, so sure, you can tap one on my lands. Snuff Out is free, and the Daze are free. Force of Negation is free. They even know I have a Daze. They just got it back from with the Foragers. So. Do I have a Sinus Bird Guide? No, they're just done. Alright, opponent playing a wild deck with literally all the weirdest card art you can possibly think of. Alright, I'll keep in the removals. Brazen Borrower is good. Fatal Push seems good. Hem to Turak seems good. Ratchet Bomb seems good because it kills Chalice. What do we cut? I don't know. What do we cut? Thoughtseize? I mean, I have to cut something. It's not that. I mean, I know that everything that I have is good here, but I have to cut something. Thoughtseize is not a blue card for my six forces, and it's a one drop in case they go off on turn one with a chalice. I might cut push on the draw, maybe on the play I can bring it back, not sure. Not even sure what I'm talking about right now. Ratchet Bomb doesn't stop infinite tokens if you're thinking about that, because the copies of Exarch still cost 3. I mean, I guess I can cut a Forager considering that I boarded in a Brazen Borrower. Yeah, let's go with this. Actually, this is 61. Alright, still cutting that Fatal Push. On the draw against Splinter Twin, I'll keep these in. Hope you don't go turn one Chalice of the Void. I guess I do have Brazen Borrower, but okay, you don't. That's good news. Alright, let's begin with a couple of cycling. Very happy to see that. And I'll go turn one Delver of Secrets here. Next turn, I can go Death Shadow. This turn, I could have gone Death Shadow if my Street Raid would have drawn more Street Raid. That's why I was cycling, because I could have fallen like 4 Street Raid, and then I can cast a Shadow 4-4 on turn 1. Ancient Tomb. Chalice on 1. Okay. Delver, do you flip? You don't. Your flip actually a good card, though. That's coming this turn. Wow. That's not actually. I thought it was Watery Grave was adding, was a fetch land. All right, then I'll go Ratchet Bomb. I prefer doing that than playing Brazen Borrower on the Chalice. I could have also done that, but yeah, this is just the cleanest way of killing that Chalice end of turn. Also prevents me from like them. Sorry, prevents them from casting another chalice because I'm just killing both of them. Whereas Blood Moon, we're going a little bit too far. I mean, there's nothing I can do about this. Huh, I have to let this resolve. Yep, definitely want to draw it. I guess I could have played a daze considering that. Ah, it doesn't matter. All right, am I picking this up or killing chalice? I mean, might as well pick this up because, yeah, like. All right, that's fine. I mean, that's a force of negation. Of course, it's too late, but it's okay. I can kill a Vlad in a couple of turns and then I can cast Ethereal Foragers. Right now, there's nothing I can do but just holding this force of negation. Point is on 11 because they tap Seed of Ancient Tomb a couple of times. Alright, they're just stopping my upkeep. Is that a Deceiver Exarch? Tapping the Insect Elaboration. Well, if it is, it's okay. I mean, oh no, what's that? Close this return. Yeah, there's nothing I can do about this. So yeah, goodbye, Delver. Pass. The Ancient Tomb doesn't deal them damage anymore because of the Blood Moon. Then I'll be able to kill end of turn with my Ratchet Bomb unless they have another Shatter effect. Although I have a Force of Negation, so I'm hoping to untap with my Ratchet Bomb with three counters on it. Pretty glad I decided to go for that. I guess with Brazen Bar also would have been good because I could float mana and then bounce the Blood Moon and then resolve. Actually, I wouldn't have cast that Force, that Forager, because I didn't have the Fort Delve in the graveyard. Game's still open. I don't feel good because they have five cards in hand and that Chalice on one isn't going anywhere because I had to use my resources on killing the Blood Moon. Okay, they just go for the end of turn, and I'll put a charge counter on this and untap with it. That's good news. Sacrifice this. Then I'll cast an Ethereal Forager, I believe. It's not going to give me any card back, but it's like threat. It's a threat. Or maybe I just go Hem to Turak. What about that? I think I'm actually, I just changed plans here. I just want to take an Hem to Turak. If they counter this, sure, you know, I could have countered anything. Hull Breacher. See, that's fine. I mean, I'm not planning to cast any cantrip because I can't. You discard a Chromox Deceiver Exarch. I'm not planning on casting any cantrip, so might as well. But I'm on 11 because my opponent, because I had two Watery Grave and two Sray Wraiths. So, you know, that's something. Sometimes this deck might just like lose his race all of a sudden. I don't know if this is the case though. All right, I go to 8. Remember, I can't cast my one drop unless I bounce that Chalice, which I might do. All right, let's see. If I draw a land, I might do that. Don't draw another Hunt to Drag. Draw step Vendilion Click. Draw step Vendilion Click. So I can play Daze, returning a Watery Grave. That will make them lose 2 life. They go down to 7. And then what do I do with my mana? I can like bounce Chalice of the Void. And then I have a land in my hand that I can play as a land drop. Chalice of the Void will come down again and I'll be forced to negation it. But my opponent knocks me down to 0 because I take 2 damage. I guess it knocks me down to 2 life, and then I can go Forager's Shadow if I draw fetch lands. Okay, so I'm seeing a line where I can win this game. And I do believe in this line, honestly. I'm a believer of this line. So I'll repeat the line for you. I'll go Brazen Bar on the Chalice. Daze the Vendilion Click. Point of pace, they go to 7. Following turn, they attack me down 2 life. Oh, I play a Watery Grave tapped. I might just not daze, but then like if I don't draw a land, that's kind of a waste. So I want to do that. Then I draw, I force a negation your chalice. Then I draw land and go Ethereal Forger's Death Shadow. All right, let's try and put this plan online. Of course, if the Vendilion click takes away any of my, Foragers or Death Shadow or Force of Negation, then I have to draw that one with the Vendilion click. But, you gotta play for winning. You have to play for winning. And I think if I just let this Vendilion click resolve, I'm not playing for winning anymore. I'm just, because, they're probably taking my Foragers. So I just wouldn't have a play at that point. I don't think Amphitoric is a play when they have one card in hand. So, and plus, I'm just getting beaten down. What did I take? They took the Force of Negation and I draw. Oh, I didn't draw anything because they have Outbreacher. Huh. See, I didn't think about this. Okay, now I'm dead. All right. Actually, am I dead? I can go Death Shadow here. Then I'm on 3 life. If I draw land, I can cast Brazen Borrower and block the Vendilion click. Plus, they're on 7, so they might actually die to my own Death Shadow. Let's see what happens. They have a Chalice of the Void in hand that I know about. And another card. The game isn't over. Basically, the days just produced the mana. Wow, they tapped the Ancient Tomb. So they have a 5 drop? Okay, I go to 3 life. They don't have Bolt in their deck. So I win if I draw... I don't know what. But I do have the days I'm doing. Okay, I'm dead. Good game. Point is playing a wild deck. For those of you who don't know what's Days Undoing, it's a time twister, but you end the turn. So, it's this card. Time twister, end turn. Alright, Flying Whales wins this one. We go to game 3. Bring back Foragers. Not sure. Maybe I don't wanna cut a one drop threat, but I mean same goes for Thoughtseize. Cutting Thoughtseize is awkward. Alright, I'll have one Thoughtseize on the play. I'll cut the Thorax. It's not easy to sideboard against the strategy because removals are good because they have the twin combo and the Hullbreacher. Counters are good, of course. I mean, cantrips, you can't cut them. You have to bat bomb. You have to keep wastelands. It's really hard to sideboard here. Yeah, let's just go with this. On the play, game 3 against blue-red weird prison. Alright, I have my one of Thoughtseize. I'm wondering whether I should just fire it off on turn 1. I don't think so, though. I have a Brazen Borrower in case they go turn 1 Chalice. Also, I have Delver. I mean, if I didn't have Delver, sure, I would have gone Thoughtseize. But I think if you have Delver against a Brazen deck, you should just leave with Delver. Because that might just, deal so much damage that, slower Brazen elements might not be enough. Yeah, I mean, with this deck, Drain Underground Sea is not great, but we'll see. Polluted Delta, okay. Shuffle. Island, pass. Okay, nice. It's a good start. Let's see if we flip. We don't. It's a Ratchet Bomb. All right, it's not bad. It's tough for one. That's actually interesting. I think I'm going for Thoughtseize. I can't cast that shot, unfortunately. If I had one Fetchland instead of Watery Grave, I would have been able to, but not. Because I only can deal only myself 7 damage. It's not enough. Alright, what do they have? Oh, I'll Breacher. Blood Moon. I think I'm taking Blood Moon here. Pretty. Wow, Ash Barons? That's crazy. Plus them fetching Island is awkward because they could have gone turn 2 Blood. Alright, whatever. I'll take Blood Moon here. Yeah, I mean, I'll take Blood Moon. Your turn, because I can fetch onto 13. And now I have the old double fetch, where if I see a bad card on top, let's say a land, I can shuffle away that land with the double. Or I can draw that land to cast that shadow. I don't know, we'll see what happens here. They can go like Hog Breacher. Okay, they go Ancient Tomb. Let's see if they go Chrome Mox Pitch the Twin. Nope, looks like they don't. Okay, we flip Ponders. I'm certainly not shuffling this one. Wonder if I should shuffle first, though. Like, do I want to draw? Yeah, no, I think you should always shuffle first in this case. Because Ponder, you know, you don't wanna only get one of the top three cards. Oh, come on, Mangu. What are you doing? Alright, sorry, I apologize for this punt. Okay, so I can't draw now because, you know, the way I played, I could have just played a land and then Brazen Bar this. I just didn't even think about it, I didn't even acknowledge this was an option. Alright, anyway, let's try to not lose it. I'm still in a good shape, I think. So here, what I can do is just Brazen Bar end of turn. That's what I'll be doing. I have to draw one card next turn among these. It's not going to be Ponder. I think it's going to be Land. It depends if I'm putting attacks on you or not. Usually, the people just attack you. So I don't think I need a Verdant Catacombs. Let's just try and do this, because I really like the Wasteland. So Shovel Liberally, no. Don't draw, you get a treasure. Attack, pass. All right. Now, probably will attack us. If they don't attack me, they play very well. And I respect that. And I'll go bounce Day's Undoing. Sorry, bounce Breacher. If they go Day's Undoing, we can bounce in response. If they don't, I'm still bouncing. I'll Breacher in response. Day's Undoing is a sorcery. They don't attack. Played very well. What now? I have a Wasteland on top. I think I'll still bounce this Hog Breacher. Because I can just cast Petty Theft. Brazen Borrow next turn. And that will be a quick clock. Let's see if they replay Brazen Bar, a Hog Breacher here. They lose 2 life by doing so. Okay, so I'm drawing this Wasteland. I'll play that and attack for 3. Then I'll pass. In their upkeep, I'll Wasteland the Ancient Tomb. And then I have Brazen Barer. Okay, they crack the treasure to play the Breacher. I'm Wastelanding the Tomb now. And do I want to play a Brazen Borrower here? No, I want to leave some mystery around what I have in hand. They keep on not attacking me. Which is a smart play. And I'll play the Bar end of turn, which resolves draw, fetch land, attack, oh, ponder. Okay, it's not a fetch land. Not gonna cast it. You go to 4, and I'll play a Ratchet Bombier. I don't want to play the ponder, because then it would give them a treasure. Let's see if they have a way out against my flyers. They don't. All right, Nyorogranda wins the match. We tried to lose it all, but that's good. This was a good match. Hog Breacher is a very powerful card. Just respect it. with you know, your Brazen Bar and so on. All right, that for round number three. Round number three with a hand that if you hide Death Shadow from this hand, it looks like any deck could be, but no, it's Death Shadow, and whenever the Death Shadow deck doesn't draw any fetch lands, yeah, it relies on the opponent actually dealing the damage, because lowering your life of 7 isn't easy. Ooh. Alright, looks like we are not playing some fair magic today. Everyone is trying to do something unfair. Oh wow, that's an Arclight Phoenix. And the Lightning Bolt. Okay. So if I wasteland, oh wow, four so four, what a great draw. I'm thinking about wastelanding, but you know what, actually, I'm on the draw, on the drawing legacy, you want to see what's up. You have two Thoughtseize. Oh wow, yeah, sure. I'll leave you with a couple of bolts. I'm so glad I didn't wasteland you. If you want to bolt me, I'd love to. Opponent doesn't know that we played that shadow. I mean, of course it won't bolt us, but maybe they draw like a free spell and they go bolt you, free spell that they draw, Arclight Phoenix, or none of the above, and pass the turn. And we draw Brazen Borrower. Okay, here I'll go Delver. I guess Wasteland, Delver, and then I'll Wasteland the Volk. Now, what happens is I want them to use a Bolt right now, so that they have one less spell to flip the Arclight Phoenix. Yeah, see, they're thinking about it, because they're like, wait, if I use this Bolt now, then I have less spell to flip the Phoenix. By flip, I mean Arclight Phoenix requires 3 spells to return. So I basically gave them a target. Usually you wasteland in upkeep, but this is actually the opposite right now. I don't want them to cast spells in their turn. I want them to cast spell in my turn, so they can't turn on the Phoenix. That's totally fine. If my Delver goes away, I've made my land drop so I can pass the turn. I'm still on 16, yeah. No need to worry. I mean, next turn if I don't draw land, I'll need to worry and have to cast Brainstorm, but okay. Fiery Islet. That's a spell that you could play. Actually, no, you can't. There's no blue-black. I guess with Modern Horizons, they will have these, right? Maybe not. All right. Ooh, Watery Grave. Okay. So if I play Watery Grave, the jig is up. Do I care if the jig is up? I don't care. Sure, they won't bolt me. That's fine. I'm not expecting them to do either way. I don't want to play Brainstorm either. Okay. Looks like they're casting a Faithless Looting. Or at least that's what I would think they do here. Which will prompt me to play a Day's Returning Water Grip. Oh, no, they're not doing that. What are they doing? Bedlam Revel. Oh, it's a Sprite Dragon. Okay, can I just bounce that one? Yes, I think I'll do that. Not blocking. I was expecting them to like bolt me or something, but no, that did not happen. Then I'll go Petty Theft. If they have a Daze, eh, we'll think about it. If they have a Daze, we'll think about it. If not, I'll just attack here. You know what? Maybe should have taken one damage. Yeah, because they have a Death Shot in hand. But they also have a Bolt and an Arclight Phoenix. Not sure. This was actually a very tough choice. I should have thought about it more. You know, if they daze this, I'm totally cool with that. I'll let it resolve. I'm not sure why they're thinking about it. Yeah, they do daze that. That's okay with me. Yeah, that's okay with me. So Petty Theft goes to their graveyard. I'm not paying. And I go to 14. They don't bolt me. Okay, reasonable. Untap, draw. Alright, so I can go that Shadow 1-1 here. I think I'll cast a Brainstorm first. Huh. Okay. All right. I'm thinking about what to do here, because I could go Thoughtseize. They go Bolt. They will go Bolt. And I go Daze. And then I can go Death Shadow. And you know what? You know what? I don't even need to shuffle. Right? So I'll just top these two. Let me think about this. I'll top these two right now. And then I'll go Thoughtseize. Opponent has is a land Volcanic Island. Sorry, Volcanic Island Bolt. So they go Bolt you. I go Daze, returning Watery Grave. Returning maybe Underground Sea or Watery Grave. Do I prefer dealing myself two damage? Yeah, all right. Yeah. This is a difficult game, but I think I might win the race. So we'll do that. Okay, so I'll top these two. And I'll Thoughtseize you. This game is difficult, but I think I saw one line here. Doesn't mean that it's the best line. I saw one line here. Opponent next turn will go Fateless Looting, which I think I have to let resolve. So I go Daze. Returning what? Returning Underground Sea? Does that make any sense? Yes. Yes. Because Stoxes knocks me down to. Not sure. Not just not sure. Just not. I'm just not sure about all the sequencing here. Maybe I should just let them bolt me. And I had a land in my hand. Right, so this was difficult. I don't think there was like a clear best play or anything like that. Anyway, here's that shadow. 1/1, but it'll be larger because you attack me with a Sprite Dragon. And if you don't attack me, then it's okay. I mean, it meant that you don't attack me. Different plays I could have done was just don't have a force. Just don't know. All right. Fateless Looting resolves. Draw two, discard two. Next turn, it's just got land spell pierce. Okay. Let's now draw a fetch land. And attack me. I have to fetch here. Elf Mothman on. Yeah, I have to fetch here. 6/6 is the Death Shadow. I'll get an Underground Sea. Or maybe a Watery Grave tapped. I certainly can't put it into play untapped because then I'm dead to any spell. I guess Watery Grave tap makes the most sense. I had to shuffle because I had a wasteland on top, which I don't want to draw. Okay, opponent is in a spot where they can't really attack me, unless they kill me, of course, but I have a force for their bolt. I'm hoping they just crack the Fiery Islet. If they play a spell, I have to let, I mean, a ponder or a four, a brainstorm, what do I do? And I guess I counter it and hope the other card is a land. Alright, it's a Sprite Dragon, huh? Huh. If I let this resolve, I lose the game, so I have to force this. I mean, I'm just forced to force it. And now if they have a spell, they can think about it. Let's see, what's that? A Delver of Secrets! All right, they attack me, and now I have to top deck. I have to top deck a removal spell for the Delver. Can't be snuff out. I'm literally on mono out right now. The fatal push. Now I guess a flyer can do it too. Brazen Borrower, Ethereal Foragers, a little bit of outs then. What's that? Brainstorm. Okay, this is three outs. And that's nothing. All right, this is a cool game though. Maybe there were different lines to win, but yeah, I'll suicide myself. But yeah, they're definitely a cool game. Definitely a cool game. I think I found a nice line to win the race, but I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Okay, we're sideboarding here against Phoenix. I don't want surgical against them. I want to push. Snuff out is risky. I mean, I guess I can keep it. Cut the thoughtsies. Yeah, I think I'm just submitting this deck as it is. I don't want to change anything. You want a cage? No, I don't want a cage against Blue Red Delver. Let's go with this. On the play for game two. Oof. This is a hand. This is not a good hand. Mulligan this end. This is a better one. I think I'll get rid of Force of Will. Assuming that these wastelands are spells. And I'll go turn one Thoughtseize. Put a Mulligan to six. Let's go Watery Grave. Lose two life, Thoughtseize. Oh, Blood Moon. Looks like it's a pretty popular theme today, huh? Alright, I'll take it. I'll take it. I'll take it also because if I take the Blood Moon, they maybe go for Volcanic Island, you know? Whereas if I... No, it looks like... No, they might still... Bungo Island? No, it's an island. Okay. Right. And we're flooded. Ay. I mean, I could have bought him a wasteland and kept a force. Ooh, flip with ponder. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll I think I'll fetch for Watery Grave tapped. I mean, I'm afraid I can't really lose too much life by myself this game. This is a thing that you have to learn when playing Shadow, is that when you have to decide whether to just go for Underground Sea slash Watery Grave tapped, or when you just have to jam those, like, you know, self-damaging card, lands. And this is a matchup where I'm expecting my opponent to hurt me a lot, so I'll just fetch a top Watery Grave this way. Okay, I'll play a whale. Not good, not very good, but I'll play a whale. Okay, one turn earlier than Gurmagangler. And if attacks, I can get back a Thoughtseize. Probably gonna get bolted, but what can you do? Or maybe not. Who knows? They didn't shuffle with the first ponder. And they did shuffle with this one. Okay. Okay, maybe they didn't find a bolt. That's scary. Two Arclight Phoenix in the graveyard. Yes, I could have dazed the Fateless Looting. And that's a bolt. Alright. I mean, I'll do the thing, but I'm dead here. As the Phoenix will rise and Mango will lose. Okay, dates back to days. I just let them do it, because you know, when you play Arclight Phoenix, you really want to just do the thing where you go to combat and boom, trigger. Alright, I'm dead. Good game. Let's be back for round number 4 with Blue Black Shadow. Round number four, with a good end on the draw. We have turn one Delver with a Force of Negation up in case they go. I was just thinking about Ancient Tomb Chalice. Oh, Seaman Spirit Guide. Am I just in the Blood Moon hour? What happens? Is it 6 p.m. Italian time zone? It's where the Blood Moon shows up? Alrighty, set to do that. Ooh, Force of Will. I think I have to leave up fours. Right? I think I have to leave up fours. Maybe Delver could have won the game on by itself, but it's just difficult to imagine that. All right, I think as I said earlier, no, actually, since I can't find a Wasteland, I'll go Ponder first. Ooh, this is very good. Very good top here. Pretty happy I didn't play Delver on turn one. Basically, I didn't shuffle with Ponder just because I had another land, like Underground Seed, so that I gave myself the options whether if I wanted to shuffle, I could have just picked up one card only. If I didn't want it to shuffle, I had that Underground Seed ready. This is Karn. It's a Smasher. That was unexpected. Okay, that's good. My shadow will thank it. All right, so we flip. Draw days. Not great, but I kind of do. Now, opponent is on 12 because of that thing. So if I fetch, the shadow is only 4/4. I really don't want to shuffle here. On top of the deck, there's a very good card. Plus, if I put in attack me for 5 more, it means that the shadow will be even bigger. This is a race here. Thoughts here. Aya. That's good. That's very good, actually, because it takes away my Death Shadow, which I could have casted, by the way. Although, I daze this by paying 2 mana. And let's see if they... Oh, wow, Seaman Spirit Guide they had. Oh, no, that's incredibly bad. That's so funny. They had a Seaman Spirit Guide to not lose the 2 life, because otherwise I would have won, because I draw, you know what I draw, right? 1/7 here. Draw that one. Oh, yo. I think I have to bounce Thanatsir right now. That's like my only chance, I think. I can't top deck. Yeah, I think I have to do that. I think I can top deck that Shadow's way. I think I lost now. I don't have any bolts in my deck. Oh no, I guess a drawing Thanatos here is drawing Death Shadow is still a thing. What did you draw? I come a Stomp. If they hadn't top deck Stomp now, I could have just double blocked that Smasher. You know, with the Foragers plus Delver, would have gone 1, and then I could have drawn a land to cast Brazen Borrower. Oh, what a crazy game this was. I mean, I would have drawn 2 dead draws, because it wasn't 2 life. So maybe I would have still lost? No, I mean, eventually I draw this one. Opponents just like shut off from casting any. I guess I could cast Thanatos here. Unclear how this game would have gone. I mean, I certainly died, but yeah. All right. That's what happens, I guess. So these three cards will come in. What goes out? This one is non-black, right? So very good in this matchup. Certainly Fatal Push. Don't really want to cut anything, honestly. I guess the Foragers once again. I'm on the play. I don't want to cut any thoughts on the play. Let's go. Okay, I'm on the play. With a keep. Now, I either cast turn one ponder, hope looking for something, or I'm just hoping that goes low and I go turn one Delver. Let's see how much they mulligan down to first. Okay, I kept seven. Yeah, I think I'll go ponder. Looking for a daze or one of my, basically 10 cards I'm looking for. Daze and forces. It's 10 cards. And I play that shadow instead of I don't even know instead of what. All right, this is a shuffle. Okay, by news, wish I had a Delver turn one rather than just exchanging Ponder with the Flawless Strand. Haven't drawn that many straight rate. That's usually the difference between this deck being good or bad. It's drawing straight rates. Same thing as the Ancient Tomb decks. Drawing Ancient Tomb is the difference between their deck being good or bad. When they draw Ancient Tomb, the deck is very, very strong. So here, with the Fetch Lands, I can only go down to 14. And that's not enough to cast Death Shadow. Yeah, same thing with Foragers. Stray Raid just makes so that both the Foragers and Shadow just, oh, I did pass, okay. All right. Oh, wow, the complaining work. I should complain more. All right, do I fetch first? Yes, I'll fetch first. So water is stopping out. Okay. I'll fetch first, go get another Watery Grave. Then Stray Rate. And then I think I'll cast both Shadow and Delver. Shadow will be a 4-4 next turn with the Flawless Strand in end. At this point, I think I have a clock, so I don't care about their hate pieces. I mean, of course, if they go Blood Moon, it's tough. But if they go Chalice, it's fine. Simia Spirit Guide. I guess it's a Thanatos here. No, two Simia Spirit Guide. Is this a turn two Smasher? It is. No days on my side. And the attack. All right, I go down to seven. My Shadow is a 6/6. Now I can cast Brainstorming Upkeep to flip the Delver. I think it's actually good. Ooh, Snuff out. Okay, I don't want a 3-rate. Wait a sec. So I can deal myself 6 damage, going down 1. That Shadow is a 12-12, I can deal 15 damage here. It's not enough. I think I don't want a straight right, thank you. And I'll put days on top. Yeah, I mean, I have to flip the over, so I'll put days on top. Now I don't attack with the shadow because that one blocks the smasher. If they have a second smasher, I can kill the other one. Here, so on top of that, there's a straight rate, which I don't want. I'm gonna cast foragers now. Do I cast it with a flawless strand, or do I really not want it? Yeah, I don't want it. Yeah, I don't want it. Okay, I decided I don't want it. All right, so we go underground sea. A foragers. With my two spell free. Opponent knows about these. I can't attack with the death shadow. What if I attack with a shadow? No, right? Then I have a chump block. No, right? No, no. Let's just play safe. The thing is that if I go enough out to attack, they can go like smasher and I'm dead. I guess I have a daze and they have three lands. Grove to burn willows. Okay. They know about my daze. And they already played two Seamus Braid Guide as well. Yeah, maybe I should have just gone snuff out. Because no, that actually then I died to stomp. Alright, let's not die to stomp. Taunts here. Alright, I'll daze that, returning this. Do they have a third Seamus Braid Guide? They don't. Alright, we just played totally fine here. Now I just go snuff out. That's a 10 and a 16 damage. Yeah. As easy as that. Okay. I'll discard a card. Alright. Could have done that last turn as well. I would have been on 3, but then I die to, I don't know, lightning bolt? No, there's definitely no lightning bolt. It's all good. I've drawn a lot of free spells. Usually when you draw free spells, you win at magic. Do I need Fatal Push to kill the Thanatseer? Maybe it's better than Thoughtseize on the draw. Yeah, Thoughtseize on the draw against a Chalice deck isn't amazing. Plague Engineer? No, I don't want Plague Engineer. It's too expensive. Let's go for game number 3. Alright, so this is, do you remember when I told you that you should mulligan hands with Street Rate? Should you though? So you have a Force of Will. Two Wasteland. Alright, let's do it for science. I'll keep. Doing it for science. I'm playing against, Eldrazi deck. Alright, I just start with a mountain. I'm assuming that's the Seamus Braid Guide. I've drawn a lot of these. That's okay, and that's a chalice. Alright. Keep the days around, because the foragers just cost 2 blue. That's just too much. Far away from that. I guess I could have cycled first. Yeah, that was better. Maybe draw like a ponder. Woohoo! Never! Didn't have it. Alright. Cycle first, yeah. Wow, flooding out. Okay, I'll play land pass here. Wish I had a foragers. Actually, Daze is good. Daze is very good. Ooh, Shadows go smashing. And another chalice. What if I go just underground sea here? Yeah, I think I'll just go underground sea here. Hope they don't have another Seamus Braid Guide. Okay, they don't. I'll kill their land there. Shadows go smashing, huh? It's an expensive mountain. Not too happy with all this snuff out, but yeah. I guess I'm just hoping they don't really function. And I'm able to just draw a threat at some point. Is that another chalice? No, it is! Oh, yo, yo. Okay. Fatal push, that's no bueno. Keep wastelanding you. Pass, pass. Okay, okay, they finished their lands. It's a good news. I draw days, that's also good news. Can I just get back those foragers? No, I mean, days was great. Was it though? I don't know. It wasn't because that three chalice. Yeah, I wish I could have pitched days over foragers. If I could turn back. I have three foragers though, I board in the third inn. Two wretched bomb. We have answers. Problem is that I'm giving my opponent time, and they'll use their time to draw their lands. Yeah, the wasteland plan doesn't go very well if you don't draw anything after that. I'm playing this over Underground Sea here. Let's just cast the snuff out and do that, losing four life. They can't cast any of their Eldrazi cards here. Oh, another Sinisbury guide. What's that? Karn? Chandra? Maybe Chandra. Oh, I think Chalice on two? Is that an ape? Okay, I'll live it. I'll live with it. I don't want days on ape. Do I want to snuff it out though? Maybe end of turn I will. Maybe end of turn I will. Bloodsun. Hey, I'll go days on this one. Yeah, I think I'm just casting a snuff out on that ape. Nah, I don't. I'm actually just getting two under a two. What's the name? To tap land end of turn. That can cast snuff out. I could also just let the Bloodsun resolve. Because, you know, once I fetch, it doesn't do much. Then they draw a card. Ay, ay, ay. That's a Thanatseer. I think I actually have to cast. Alright, let's draw a card first and then I'll decide. Yeah. I mean, that will discard that, so. At least now they discard a card that I can cast anyway. I'll pass. Let's see. Okay. Drowsy Temple. With two cards in hand. Oh, Fiery Confluence, okay. So I go to two life now. Yeah, I don't think I have any more outs. Alright, good game. Be back for round number 5. Hopefully I won't play against another Blood Moon deck. Mega Point actually doesn't play Blood Moon. Mega Point only Blood Sun. Yeah, could be. Alright, be back for round number 5. final round of this league with what looks like a mulligan to me. All right, let's keep this one. What if I bought him a brainstorm? I have turn one thoughts, his turn two foragers. Because there's one, two, three. Maybe four. All right, I'll go water a grave, of course. Thoughtseize. I'm holding the straight rate. Uro Mux Diamond. Huh. Went and held the Mux Diamond, and I guess they will regret their choice. Although I've seen a Ghost Quarter here, which is as good as a straight mine can be. Let's see if they'll Ghost Quarter me. Yep, that's fine. Nope. Okay, that's a good one. All right, now I'll cycle, because if I find a fetch land, I draw to play that, then water a grave. I don't soul play that shadow. Days will be cast on Uro on turn three, or oh, wow, Maze of It. Sure, I'll wasteland that one. Good card in sideboard of old school decks. Good card in main deck of legacy decks. No, if I knew the matchup, I would have bought him Fatal Push and kept Brainstorm, but that's fine. I'm holding it together here. We don't land that can cast this Foragers. I couldn't have cast, second Maze of It. I couldn't have cast Gurmagangler anyway. Okay, that's a good draw. I'll attack, my opponent will untap it. And I cast Foragers. Returning. Unfortunately, I don't have any cantrips, so it's not great, but that's okay. I'll return a Thoughtseize later. It's quite unfortunate to not have any cantrip when you cast your Foragers. But this certainly looks like a matchup where I am able to send in an attack. That's the problem with Foragers, right? Because it dies to Bolt. Not now. All right, play Blazone. So they would choose not to go for Uro. Interesting choice. I got Thoughtseize back. They'll take three and I'll discard their Uro. They have three cards. I guess they can have other things. What's that? A punishing fire? Target me. Okay. I don't want to play Delver because that one dies to the Blast Zone, so I'm passing the turn. I'm on four life, but I do have a three turn clock, not a three turn clock, a five turn clock, I guess, with the Foragers. But if I find a Wasteland, it's not over immediately, but we're in a good shape. We would be in a good shape. All right, anyway, they can now kill the Death Shadow and untap the Foragers. So I'll play a Delver. Yeah, I'm really wishing that Brainstorm wasn't put on the bottom of my deck. But this Fatal Push was. Alright, they go Wasteland, which can't let them cast Uro. It looks like they're drawing another spell here. It's a Valakun Exploration. Huh. So I can double daze this. Or I'm just letting it resolve. Obviously I'm not thrilled that I have it, but now if they play draw a land, they can like basically reveal the top card and so on and so forth. I can save my Watery Grave because I can push my foragers and daze it. Is that worth it? Probably is. Maybe not. Is it or not? Because, like, this way, if they draw a land to cast Uro, I'm able to daze the Uro. And then if they cast it again, I'm able to daze it again. But in this other way, if I draw a Foragers or a Petty Theft, yeah, I think I will push the Foragers and daze it. The push will resolve, but the Foragers cost six. Sorry, actually, the push doesn't resolve, but I'm dazing it. I could have pushed Delver as well. All right, let's see if we flip. Underground Sea. So, yeah, the play was awful. Classic. I'll play this Underground Sea now. Classic, like you just make a cute play and it's just wrong. But what if I drop foragers? I would have complained about it, but there's just obviously more lands than foragers. Exploration, sure, that's not a very good draw. Okay, I draw Brazen Borrower, which I'll use to bounce the Mox Diamond here. Bouncing Mox Diamond is a strong play. I'll play Watery Grave, tapped. Now bounce the Mox Diamond. Now they're not able to cast Uro. And I'm able to cast Brazen Borrower next turn. They draw Thespian Stage and the Exile of Wasteland, okay, which they can play. They reveal a Crop Rotation. Ha! Opponent's able to make a 20-20 out of literally not a single card. That's just crazy. They have nothing, they have two lands and they made a 20-20. That's amazing. All right, if I daze, they aren't able to do that though. Crop Rotation resolves. They got Voodoo Foothills. Huh, okay. Which will. Okay, so they deal me one with the Valakut Exploration. All right, we flip. With the first cantrip of the game, coming in on turn nine. Coming in hot on turn 9, Ponder. Right, so they have it the. I mean, I don't think I can just do much. Just Wasteland this Maze of it. You can attack. You can like copy it with Thespian Stage. Not gonna do much. You go to 6. Maybe I die to Valakut Exploration dealing me damage, but I don't really feel like I have that much of a choice right now. You go to 5. Oh wow, there's a crop rotation which is gonna stay until their turn. They drew a Rishadan port. That's a forest. They played a forest. No? Maybe there's something else in their mind. Maybe they make a 20-20. No, Wood of Foothills. Oh yeah, that one just kills me. Funny. Exactly, because they fetch now. It's three cards under the Valakut Exploration, and then boom, just deals me three. Yeah. I mean, I would have lost to 20-20 regardless. But this is obviously a cleaner way to defeat me. All right, good game. Basically, we've lost to lands that really didn't do very much. We just like Maze of It, and I guess we didn't really function as well. We didn't ever draw a cantrip. Okay, so finally time for our surgicals. I'm not sure about Ratchet Bombs. Cut pushing snuff out. If they draw a Evish Reclaimer, it'll be tough, but I guess I can live with that. Maybe I keep in some removals before the Elvish Reclaimer. Or maybe I just have Ratchet Bomb for that. Side like this. Yeah. Let's go like this. Only play against lands. Keep this hand isn't very strong. Not bottoming any Brainstorm this time around. Rishadan port and pass the turn. Wow, okay. You know what? I want to flip this Delver and kill you as fast as possible. That's the name of this game. Doesn't really matter what I do. Hollow Wasteland and attack for three. Want to do it before they were able to crop rotation. Plus, of course, I want to hit my land drop. Okay. That was the reason to not play, Brainstorming Upkeep. It's a play I like to do whenever I need both. I'm against a combo deck and already have like a turn lined up that I don't have to dig for or anything, which is what I believed was the case. All right, so I can draw a land now or not, and I go to 11 here. Loam, Sphere of Resistance. That's interesting sideboard on the draw. But yeah, that got the counter. They got an 8. Let's see. Let's see what's next here. Hopefully it's just a Valakut Exploration, not an Uro. It looks like an Uro. Titan of Nature's Wrath. Going to 10. Putting Grove in play and playing Drop of Honey. Drop of Honey, the very expensive Arabian Nights card that I was going to give up, but guess I'm still playing. Very hard to beat Drop of Honey. You just have to let it pop it up. It's like in the upkeep now, they'll kill my Delver. And the turn after, there's no creature, Drop of Honey will die. Oh no, sorry, I was wrong. That one, yeah, okay. I thought it was okay, then it's not that hard to beat it. Yeah, I'll let them go doing I'll let them go in draw step, and then I'll surgical the Uro. Instead I can cast it already. Oh wow, yeah, the Uro in hand. It's a good catch. Good catch. Two sphere of resistance. Alright, I don't wanna play against two sphere of resistance with no ends. Okay, that's the end of this league. We started strong with a 2-0. I ended on a 2-3. Ouch! Ouch! I mean, I guess we play against two Blood Moon. This deck is really, really bad against Blood Moon. Because you don't have, I mean, I guess you have forces. I don't know. The previous game against Lance, if I had the kept Brainstorm over push, I would have probably won. But I don't know, I just felt like my opponent was playing creatures. You know, you have this read and you probably just keep the Brainstorm. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I'll be back next time for more Legacy video. And have a good week, everybody.